All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to another Tuesdays As Yet Unnamed comedy show. Let's get a big round of applause for your host for the evening, Lisa Pockets. Also shitty sets, and we switch them, and we try to do their version, right? So, because I'm the only one that fully committed to the bit, because everyone else is a pussy! Yeah! Yeah! Oh, it's good to be a man. Tonight, I am Harley Bushdiker. That is who I'm sitting with. Yes, walk away, sweat. And then, Harley, do you want to share who you are tonight?
I hate you. That's what I am. You're a fucking white man. I just can't stand you. But I also kind of want to rub my labia on you. So, I don't know.
I don't know what that is.
I got mixed feelings.
Because I'm a man. That was the joke. So who are you?
I'm you. I am the Honorable Lisa Pockets.
Yeah. Mm.
She sounds hot. And I don't know. Hopefully smells good. Horny. Yeah, she's fine. Alright, so that was me explaining the show, but let me go ahead and explain to you about how beautiful and perfect our bartender is. Guys, let's give it up for Juice real quick. Your bartender! Juice. Sorry, I have to remind myself to get into character. Hey, Juice. Hey, bros. Juice, what are the specials tonight?
$5 double
L. $5 double L. That's
$2.50.
I was waiting for Lisa to do it, but women are stupid. You don't pay, they don't
I
need...
just couldn't handle the task.
I know, it's too much. You're just thinking about the Barbie movie, I get it. What else, Juice?
$2 high life.
$2 high life? Who likes to fuck with high life? Anybody?
Hey.
I'm poor too, so I get it. Harley's poor. Lisa makes okay amount of money.
That's what that master's degree is for.
It's nothing to brag about. Great. Hey. And that's... Do I have to explain anything else, Lisa?
I think... Do you guys understand everything that's about to happen?
It's okay if you say no. That's fine. That's actually preferable. I'd rather you guys not be aware of anything that's about to happen.
All right. Go for it.
Let's do it. All right. Hey, guys. Wow. I love being Harley. Look at this great hat. My dad made it. Just kidding, never met him. Hey, so man, I'm just doing like a toned down Macho Man Randy Savage. So I like to smoke weed. Bros, where my bros at? Where my bros at? I like to smoke weed. Yes. I like to smoke weed and chat about life's questions. Because, you know, I almost got a psychology degree. That's a good one. But, you know, I was talking with my buddies when we were smoking. And out of nowhere, he was like, hey, dude, what's your favorite sex position? And I'm like... Yo! yeah, this whore gave me his set today! So look, this is what you're working with. So, my favorite sex position, dude, Harley, is when I'm like fucking a girl and I have her ankles up her ears, and then I'm just hitting it. You know, and then they start screaming. And then I said, bro, man, they're screaming? And he goes, yeah, they're screaming. And then I said, probably because you just tore their fucking hamstrings. They're probably screaming because they didn't fucking stretch. How about I get you down and fucking put your ankles behind your fucking head and we'll see what happens. And also, can I have sex with you? As I imagine is how that story's supposed to go. But Harley's not in tune yet with his sexuality. And that's okay, we're all learning. I'm learning. It's a lot of fourth wall breaking. I'm so sorry, you guys. This is the most I prepared. I did spray half my hair and I did put on a fake goatee with makeup.
Thank you.
Harley's gonna wear one of my outfits later, so you guys just fucking wait. It's gonna get horny. If you guys aren't already horned up by a kind of fat girl in sweatpants, I don't know what you're doing here. I don't know. If you see me with the pants and the cowboy hat, like, you don't belong in this bar if you didn't immediately get an erection or a hard clit. Like, what? Thank you for nodding. I'll get your digits later. Okay. I don't know, guys. It seems hard. Must be hard to be you. Are you timing me at all?
Oh, fuck no.
Lisa, you dumb cunt.
I literally can't handle any time.
I know. It's too much. It's too much. Oh, it's too much for your brain. So that has developed as a man's. So, you know, when I was talking with my bro, I was like, man, what's my favorite sex position? You know?
But now that I'm
close,
it is.
My favorite sex position... What? Okay, was this one time... Because I guess he's only had sex once. Was this one time... where he was on, where I was on top of a woman, I was penetrating a woman with my apparatus.
I would never say apparatus.
Now Harley can't even spell it.
I can.
Lisa can. But I was fucking her as on top, right? Which is cool. Like, I like that, but that's not my favorite sex position. My favorite sex position was what happened right after this. So I was like, hey, let's do missionary, like God intended. And I took that whore by the shoulders. I don't even like saying that. I took that whore by the shoulders, and I was like, I'm just going to roll her over, you know? And it'll be like a sexy, like, tumble time, you know? Like men and women do. And so I took her by the shoulders and I rolled her over, but I forgot which side of the bed we were on, so I just bombed her into the ground. And that is the deepest I've ever been in a woman. Well, other than that one girl, Daisy, who's my friend, well, my cousin, not my friend. I added that part. That part's my joke. Because Harley looks like he's at least gone to third base with his cousin. Minimum hand stuff. You have a microphone. That's fine. Okay. Guys, I think I've taken up enough of your time. I got more of these, so they're just going to be sprinkled on in. But you guys are going to get to see Transsexual Kid Rock all night.
You're at 2 minutes now.
What?
You're at 2 minutes now.
Oh, great. I must be high.
I just don't know when it's my time to talk, you know? Like, when's my time?
That's true. You know, women have a hard time advocating for themselves. Y'all see the Barbie movie? I know I'm Harley, but I want to talk about the Barbie movie so bad. Such a bad time to be a man. Guys, we're going to bring up our first comedian, and boy howdy, he's a real humdinger, and he's going to give it... Okay. Guys, give it up for Brian Walker!
So I will be playing the part of Joe Butler tonight. Everybody look at Joe and make it awkward right there. And play him, Joe. So I read some dietary advice recently. It said count colors, not calories. Like, the more colored food you have on your plate, the more nutritious it's going to be. So now I only eat Fruity Pebbles. And if I feel like I'm not getting enough nutrition, I carry a little thing of sprinkles around with me and just, bah. It's probably why I got diabetes. Me, not Joe. Joe didn't have diabetes. Yeah, count colors, not calories. How does that work for cannibalism? I just imagine like a cannibal couple arguing over not where but who to eat that night. Like, well, look, I told you we need to have more color in our diet. We need to stop eating at those NRA meetings, okay? Well, I'm not taking Hindu again. Indian food does not agree with me, you know? Yeah. All right, can cannibals be racist, or is that just being a picky eater? Is that... Like, personally, I would not eat a Chinese person. I'm not racist. I just don't want to be hungry later. Like, I need, like, a thick cut of German, but, like, not Nazi German, because that makes you gassy. So I was having trouble falling asleep the other day. It's too late. I'm in the next joke. I was having trouble falling asleep the other day, and I heard that white noise is a good way to fall asleep. So now I fall asleep to the audio of the Capitol riots. Knocks me right out, man. Just like a baton to the skull, just... I have a degree in plant science.
Yeah.
It's actually a bachelor's degree, so I have a BS in plant science, which is just a big green load of BS, if you ask me. Because, like, the whole class was just, like, sitting in a classroom trying to learn about plants. We didn't go outside. We didn't get our hands dirty or anything like that. Like, I feel like if you learn about plants in a classroom, I feel like learning about plants in the classroom is the same as learning about sex in the classroom. You're either really terrible at it or you had a terrific teacher. You ever forget the entire part of the next joke? What's next, Joe? Come on! No. People come up and like, because I have a BS in plant science, they just think that I'm the authority on all plants. Like, somebody will come up with a picture from their garden and be like, why are my cucumbers growing right? Like, I don't fucking know. Like, some plant scientist you are. Like, fuck, like, that's not fair to me. Like, imagine you took a picture of your grandpa who's been in a coma for 3 years to a doctor and been like, can you tell me what's wrong with people? Come on. We don't know what's wrong with every vegetable, okay? Give it a second. Like, what advice am I going to give there? Like, I don't know, put him in the sun for a minute. Maybe that'll help him. Soak his feet for a second. Like, I don't know, that's all I got. Speaking of, you guys know what soaking is? Oh, this is going to be a great night. So soaking is where some of the hornier Mormons have decided that the actual penetration part of sex is not a sin, but the friction is. So what they do is they lay down, insert it, and that's it. Just motionless, but plugged in like a thumb drive, you know? So that God can't see them have sex. And while that might fool God, it is not gonna fool a Mormon father walking into his daughter's room. Nobody's ever gonna go, hey, what the fuck were you doing? What are you doing? Wait a second. You guys are just soaking? Oh, thank Christ. Oh, my God. Oh, I thought you were taking my daughter's virginity. It turns out you were just docking for a little bit trying to make a pickle. I get it. It's fine. I was never here. And to complicate things further, some Mormons think that the friction part's okay, but the act of thrusting, the act of actually doing something. So they invented something called jump humping. Jump humping is basically just soaking with extra steps. The extra step is you have to get a third party to come over to your house and jump on the mattress so that the two soaking people are not involved, basically. Think about the blue balls you would have to call up one of your friends and be like, hey, I'm trying to jump up this girl tonight. You want to come over? It's just like, Yeah, Jebediah? Yeah, it's me, Jebediah. What are you doing Friday night? Me and Sarah, we're thinking about taking things to the next level, but as you know, we don't want to be seen as whores in the eyes of God, so we were wondering if you could come over and just, like, jump on our mattress for a bit while we soak on it? How long? Until I make leg knob, basically. That's when you'd be really helping out a brother in Christ, I swear. Well, a brother in Sarah, actually, but you know what I mean. Ladies and gentlemen, we've come to that part of the show now. I don't know if anybody knows this, but Joe Butler has an alter ego that he sometimes brings on stage. Named Bo Jutler. I'm getting there. Stop, Lisa.
You
dumb cunt. Anyway.
People are
insane. I'm sorry. This is what this night is, okay? I am going to, for one night only, be Ryan Bulker. All right? I'm going to turn the hat around. We're going to do some Mojeller material. Here we go. So I have a friend who is a film food critic, and she is very critical. Like, she rates every single one of her meals as making her want to throw up. She's bulimic. And that's not an excuse to not give a good review. I mean, you tasted it twice. I had a neighbor that would always say, if it's worth doing once, it's worth doing twice. His wife always had two black eyes. This is why he has an alter ego for these jokes, guys. Because he can't associate himself with them, so he projects. Anyway. My neighbor used to have a saying, he'd say, measure twice, or his uncle. I fucked up the whole thing. It was uncle. His uncle had a saying where measure twice, cut once. The slits on his wrists were so immaculate. The same size and depth. It was fantastic. It was perfect. Alright, I'll leave you guys with this. Why'd the terrorist throw his phone into a building? He had it in airplane mode.
I didn't even know you could make Joe Butler way less fuckable. But when Joe Butler was played by Brian Walker, I was like, wow, I'd rather die. Leave it to him to make Mormon sex. Well, that's, you know, I feel like he had to ask consent to talk to us about sex. He's not allowed within 500 feet of a school. Anybody? Fucking hate Brian. All right, hey, guys. That's Harley talking, guys. That's Harley being wild and out of control. Look at my PBR hat. Aren't I quirky? I'm so fucking quirky and smart. Because I'm a dude. Fucking hate it here. Okay, hey, guys. Let's keep it going, huh? Guys, I promise you do want to fuck up. Look how fucking cute he is. Guys, please welcome Joe Butler.
Why are there so many goddamn stairs to the stage? Fucking coronary over here. So if you guys can't tell, I am doing Brian Walker's jokes tonight. I will be using my phone to reference these jokes. I had written material, but I method acted so hard that I ate them, so stuck to being digital. Every time I met that Joe Butler guy, he's real hot, man. He's got like an awesome set of abs. I'm like, look at this shit. Like, that's just. I got a lot of work to do, man. It took being another person for that to happen. Soak it up. I got a beret, at least normally. But next to. I need blood sugar. I'm having trouble.
I thought you were just doing Mitch McConnell for a second.
Yeah. Oh. I'm gonna read some of these jokes here. I'm gonna read some of them. I don't want to brag, but I'm a JCPenney Gold member. You know, these man tits need all the support they can get. And on the front of one JCPenney store was a bra that said, "Get a bra according to your astrological sign." And I don't think anyone wants that. Like Sagittarius. Like, no one wants to see those Sagitt tits. And no one wants to see cancer tits.
He's quoting directly too. It's
sad. I'm a big fan of porn by my demeanor. I watch it a lot. I watched this video about Easter porn. That was something else. The eggs looked really tasty, but that's something else. They were doing their Easter time sexing. It was a Good Friday. But it was weird though, because they never actually said that they were, there was nothing Easter to be found in that video. Like, there wasn't a bunny butt plug. There wasn't chocolate being eaten off of someone's ass. There was no clear sign that anything related to Easter was happening whatsoever. I mean, I would have been down for the slightest bit of clue. Like, if they had just been a normal porn video and at the end they're Happy Easter, I would have been that's acceptable. I watched it three times, twice to completion, and I couldn't find any clues. So I'm fat. Not fat, technically. Obese is the technical term, you know. I think it sounds like an instrument, like a woodwind or something. Like obese sounds like an oboe. I mean, but I don't have the wind to play a woodwind, dude. And getting up on this stage was like a freaking marathon. It was rough. What came first, the chicken or the egg? I don't know, but I'll tell you one thing. I come to both of them. They're both so salivating, so tasty. They're making Ariel black. That's a thing that's happening. Ariel's black. As a big guy, I'm in support of fish pussy that is large enough to fit my fat cock. You're welcome. People argue, well, Ariel can't be black. That's unnatural. To that I say, mermaids aren't natural at all. So, why are you playing the nature card when it comes to fantastic beasts? That's like seeing a dragon with an Asian voice actor and be like, no, they come from the middle of the earth. What the fuck? They're not. That's not the dialect they have down at the magma core of the planets. So I'm an IT guy, and I got into IT because I really like the idea of kernel patches. Just because I'm hungry for kernels, popcorn kernels. I'm always hungry. Hi, Walker. I've operated with thin privilege for 24 years. It's a weird mindset change. Meth! That's fun. I'm interested in this whole meth thing because, I'm obviously trying to shed some LBs. And does anyone know how much meth it takes to, lose your gut but keep your teeth? Does anyone have... real talk, though, I think being a meth addict is actually, a really good workout. I've been looking into it as a fitness regimen. I think it's exciting, you know? You have to run away from the cops if you're caught with the drugs. That's good cardio. When you have sex for the drugs, everyone has a higher body fat percentage than you, so it's always, a bit of a bench press workout. So I'm assuming meth heads, on their back. It's an easy way to inject. Bruce Willis has dementia. That's gotta be fun. He just has the privilege that so many actors don't. They can just he can just forget all the shitty roles he's been in. I've been weighing him down, like Over the Hedge, all of the red movies, G.I. Joe. You just forget that stuff's in the cosmic way. My wife's a burlesque dancer.
True.
She can really throw it back. I know how to pick them. Every night at one of her shows, I always buy the entire front row so she can feel beautiful. I don't know. I've never seen Brian's wife. She's probably the smoke.
She's hot, man.
Yeah, she's probably a smoke.
Smoke.
That's all I can assume. Smoke.
No, I say that on occasion. Oh!
Oh! How about we stop comparing women to objects, okay?
Yeah. Sorry.
Okay, Lisa.
Yeah, sorry.
Man, fuck women, dude.
I, Brian Walker, have a lot to work on. Got some problems. So yeah, I'm an IT, like I said. I work with computers all the time, as if you couldn't tell. I'm built for this job. It's sedentary. It's easy to stare at screens for a really long time when that's your life outside of work. People come to me for advice, being like, oh, you must know about computers because you look like the guy from the World of Warcraft episode of South Park. Does anyone have any insulin on crash? Getting the shakes, you see it? I need some in the veins. No, actually, I'm going to be honest. From the perspective of Brian Walker, I'm going to say some things that Brian Walker's too humble to say. I'm a lot funnier than all of you here. I've got, like, all these jokes that you guys just don't get. And I'll show you someday.
All the time as a man. Anybody here fuck? That's not how Harley would ask it. I'm being way meaner and aggressive than Harley ever is. But it's the hat. I feel like I'm gonna vote Republican tomorrow. You know? Is this what they feel like? I feel so powerful, you know. That's probably why they're so stupid. Oh boy. What are we doing?
I thought we were getting ready to do cocaine in the bathroom.
Oh, okay.
So you were kind of talking about voting Republican and whatnot. I don't know what was that.
We'll do that. Yeah, we'll do that later. Great. Hey, speaking of cocaine, this next guy maybe has done it. I don't know. You guys judge for yourselves. Guys, join me in welcoming the wonderful Ethan Sutton.
I'm sorry. You are what you eat. Yesterday, I ate Becky Polachek's pussy. I'm sorry. Ethan Sutton ate my pussy. So I ate him. There once was a lady who swallowed a guy. He looked in the eye, between my thighs. He said, wow, it's so bushy. Then I swallowed him with my pussy. All right, let's do this. Sorry, I was late to the stage because I was writing that. I was late for my period, because Harley Bushdiger.
Yeah, brother!
That's not why, I just don't have it. That's not why I just don't have it. Look, it's... They invented adult diapers that you can't see before underwear that hides boners, which is bullshit. I went through my sister's underwear, as one does, to do some quality sniffing. Let me read you that one. If I had enough acid or like too little. All right. I went through my sister's underwear, as one does, to do some quality sniffing. Then I found period panties. Who the hell wears these? Period panties. I wonder if they have period swim shorts. That would be like the worst tea ever if you're swimming in the public pool. Mom washes her Keurig menstrual cup in the dishwasher. Now I don't eat dinner there. You want to buy me dinner? This is a side tangent. Has anyone heard of Ozempic? Yeah. Okay. It gives you the good parts of AIDS. Like having gay sex, then throwing up. All right, back to your regularly scheduled slow jam. Here we go. I took my little sister to get her nipples pierced at Claire's. Drawing a little sharpie. Some fucking dyke looking bitch telling you to put that spray on her fucking 2 times a week. Get out of here. Same bitch who does your piercings at Claire's scoops up your ice cream at Sparky's. Fucking come fight me. They got roaches in the back. It's like Joe's apartment. Go look that up on IMDb. Okay, back to your regularly scheduled Trojan. When I was little, my dad drove me to school one day and he said, "You know, seatbelts don't fit me, but neither do condoms." That's wordplay. I always had the feeling that my parents didn't want me because I used to get in the car and, like, when they did, my dad would just turn the passenger airbag off. Just like, how horrible is that? Somebody explain this to me. Some of you, one douchebag in this crowd has got to be able to, like, one of those dudes who knows
rubber
wedding ring type motherfuckers, who knows. He's over there hitting a big old vape box, like, fucking. Somebody tell me why passenger airbags are even an option. Like, that should just be a thing, right? Like, you're just like, either I want this motherfucker riding in the car or I don't. Like, I don't know. Okay. Back to your regularly scheduled Christopher Nolan. Okay. Dating in a small town is like pissing in a pool. Which basically means there's only so many people I can ask to piss on me before y'all start talking to each other. I think piss is gross, but I eat ass so hard I'm hip to speech. But oh shit, never mind. We'll see what that means. My doctor's name is Dr. Tanassian, which I find exceedingly difficult to pronounce. So when I write it on my calendar that I have an appointment, I just write Dr. T. And every time I pass the calendar, I think it's really funny because Dr. T just kind of sounds like if Mr. T had taken a different route in life. And then I wondered if maybe he had smoked a little bit more weed, maybe he would have been ART. If he would have gone on a harder psychedelic, maybe DMT. But he's gangster as a motherfucker, and that's why you'll see him on the BET. Mr. T makes me WET. My life's like a movie, but that's just because I don't wash my glasses. If my life was a movie, it would be a documentary. probably on the Learning Disability Channel. My name is Ethan, and that's been the Hallmark story of Becky Polacek. Y'all have a good evening.
And guys, I have never seen Becky that fucked up, dude. Whoa, she was slammed, dude. Shit.
And we've all seen Becky like rip a bunch of cards before.
It's great. I did see you piss in a fridge once though, because you were so blacked out. That's not a story about Ethan. That's just a story about my friend over here. My dear friend that I heartily cherish, Becky Polacek. Guys, please welcome one of my most favorite comedians in the goddamn world, Becky Polacek! Thank you! Thank you! Oh man, Ethan wishes I'd eat him. And he also wants to fuck me really, really bad. Anybody catch on to that? And it's like Ethan just asked. You know, just ask, it's fine. Alright, so I've got Ethan's notes here, and I'm now Ethan Sutton, so bear with me, I'm so sorry. So sorry. No, I slept with a girl whose safety word was uncle. Oddly enough, her dad hated it. What if you could have a pregnancy test that would just tell you whether or not to abort the baby? I said, you can! It's called the gender reveal. Oh, I didn't want a girl. I want a boy. Fuck. Oh, Lord. I pushed somebody in a wheelchair. Yes, Ethan pushed them out of their chair and said, walk! And the guy had no legs, but he still kicked Ethan's ass. No legs. With his elbows, because he had no hands either. I don't know. Two midgets probably sound like dog toys when they have sex. That's what he wrote verbatim. I'm sorry. So sorry. I just want you to notice the word probably in that sentence, as if Ethan doesn't exclusively watch little people porn. Exclusively. I was trying to make a joke that was not racist in response to one of his actually racist jokes. And then I was like, no, we're just gonna skip it. Oh my god. Oh, and then, okay, I've just got some of his notes. We'll see if I can riff, because I ran out of time to write notes. Woo! All right. Sometimes you run out of toilet paper and have to use what's in the trash can. Well, sometimes there's like banana peels in there. That would work. What's in my trash can right now? It's old stick of deodorant. That might do the trick. Maybe. I could scoop it out of there with like the bottom part. Use condoms. You don't want to do that. No, I'm sorry. That's gross. I hate cat people, so basically fuck lesbians. Ethan does exclusively fuck lesbians. Also, I'm a cat person, and I can't get any woman to sleep with me, so I don't think that this joke holds up. I actually cry into a jar every time that I cry. It's because I want to clone myself later. I want to live longer, so I'm going to clone myself as a baby and then raise myself. It's not weird. It's just what I'm going to do. Y'all ever think that Anne Frank is, like, hot? Let's see how that works. Did he read the unabridged version of her diary? Does anybody know what I'm talking about?
Yes.
Okay, some of you get it. I don't know if he does, but some of us did find her hot. When we were also nine. Eat my dust, Grandma said as I ate her out. Okay. It's because she's been cremated recently. Thank you. One person's like, that's funny. Do you think whenever an autistic person falls down the stairs, they just automatically count them? That's kind of funny. That's kind of fucked up. Ethan's allowed to tell that joke. He's autistic. It's fine. It's fine. He's allowed to tell that joke. Frozen pizza is a lot like sex. Somewhere in an unhappy family is having it. I've actually eaten frozen pizza many times with my family. And I've always, you know, had sex with them afterwards, so. I'm Ethan. If you're gonna boo Ethan. I bought a mirror at self-checkout. That's cute. Good job, Ethan. That's a cute one. 22 people died in Egypt after a bus accident, and I wonder if it's because the street signs were in hieroglyphs. Okay, I don't have anything for that. What if the two types of Indians switched place for a day? You know, Columbus thought they did. I only want to have sex with Becky. Am I clear? Am I being clear? Okay, good. Thank you. Those are my parents. Just my mom, because we already established I don't have a dad. I'm Harley, guys. That's the... Hey, everybody! Let's keep it rocking and rolling with our next set of Set Swap comedians. Guys, give a hearty welcome to Mike Callahan, everybody!
What's up, everybody? I'm Xavier tonight. I think Xavier would point out that Anne Frank probably is hot because she's in an attic and it's probably pretty hot up there. And I don't know if that's got to be the most boring diaries, like day one in the attic, day two in the attic. Anyway, one thing about me, I've got a drinking problem and two cats. So we just sit around and watch each other puke, basically. Sometimes a cat will eat up the puke, you know, whether I do or not. Growing up, y'all ever had one of those friends that was just like a really rich friend? You know, I grew up poor as hell, so... you know, I thought my friend was really rich because he had a printer and a blender. You know, those to me spelled wealth. It was cool because we got to sit around and drink smoothies and read Mad Libs. Everything, you know, Mad Libs read the same as a kid as I do for an alcoholic. You know, it's like they talk the same. My pizza is on the fire. It cost me two hand jobs. I read those with my drunk cat, and he's like, I have a meow on the bed. It's covered with a meow. It says that because he's a cat. You ever have your animal get on bed while you're having sex with you? They're not. Hold on. Hold on. Whoa, whoa. Hey, Xavier, I don't know what the hell you've been getting into, but it's kind of weird. I had a theory about this. You know, maybe it's because Xavier had a 90-pound pit bull, and he was just doing that Mormon thing, and he didn't have a friend in the like, just jump up and down. But then when he wants to do it himself, he's got to get the dog off his bed. So it's kind of like, you know, a white cop and a black teen, where he's just like, just get on the ground. It's like, I didn't do anything. That is Xavier's joke, man. Well, funny story, I'm at work and I'm writing this stuff up, and I'm like, there's a lot of shit that I cannot have on my computer screen right now. And that was definitely one of them. I'll come up with the other one later. I love going to theaters, but I hate when I spend a bunch of money and dab a few many times and then spend $30 on this movie and then I fall asleep and then I wake up at the end of Avatar 2 and I'm like, no! Play it back! So, same thing, I drive home because I'm so stoned. I wreck my car. And I wake up to like, play it back! It doesn't work that way, though. I live and work in Jeff City, and so if you're in the Jeff City area, one of the things is everybody's pretty much got the same internet in Jeff City. If you're in Jeff City, you've got CenturyLink internet, right? And I live about a block down from the governor's mansion. So that means that, if I'm at home and I'm struggling with my Wi-Fi and I can't watch my transporn, that means that Mike Parsons is also up in his governor's mansion, and he can't watch his transporn either. You know, he's like, now I got to see some Puerto Rican tits.
Yeah.
Yeah. I work at a coffee shop, and the governor comes in like every day. Like I know him on a first name basis. He comes in, and I'm like, Mike, it's me, your best friend Xavier. And he's like, who the fuck are you? Funny story, kid. You're that guy that likes to transport. That was the other thing that I could not put up on my computer screen. People can't be walking by and be like, transport? So, transportation? That was the perfect one there. So, that's all I got from Xavier. So, I'll do it. One of the things that got me into comedy, or the opportunity, was I had this elderly neighbor for the past 8 years or so, and he would just do enough funny shit that I'm like, I gotta be able to make a show out of this. An example, I'm going down to do laundry. We have this common basement, and one day I'm doing laundry, and I notice an extension cord running out of my dryer, up the ceiling, and into his apartment. And I'm like, what the fuck is this? Knock on the door. Ken, what's going on here? The MediaCom, that's the other thing. MediaCom is all over Jeff City. We're not going to talk about that, though. Anyway, the cable guy couldn't follow up, find a place to plug in his TV, so he ran an extension cord. And I'm like, oh, well, that definitely explains all the splitters and the fucking space heaters. But it was weird because, like, when COVID happened, everything was shut down, and there was like a month period there where Ken was the only one I talked to, and he kind of became like this adopted grandfather. And really, we ended up getting too close. Like one day I'm over there and he's like, Mike, can you cut my toenail? And I'm like, well, how did I get myself in this? And I did it that one time, but then I got in the phone book. I'm like, all right, we're taking you to a place that cuts nails for a living, because this is not, I will pay for it if I have to. He's like, no, I got it. We set up an appointment. I tell him, you have to tip him $5. $5? That's way too much money. Ken, I'm not taking you if you don't tip this girl $5 for touching your nasty-ass feet. And so we go there, and the women fall in love with him. They're, like, bringing him his paper and stuff, and I have to watch him go up to pay. And one time he goes up to pay, and I see him getting ready to give her the $5, and I see a thought in his head. I'm like, uh-oh. He puts a $5 in his pocket, and he brings up a change purse and just starts shaking it over the counter. And pennies and nickels and dimes are falling all over the place. And I was like, oh, dear God. That actually just reminded me of another Xavier joke that I forgot I didn't have. Anyway, Xavier liked to... I'm Xavier. So I like this thing I like to do where I get these silver dollar coins and I get a collection of them and I'll go to the grocery store and I'll see like, somebody's ass crack and I'll just flick them in there and my aiming is impeccable, guys. And you know, you always think for a minute they're really angry at you, but then they realize, wait, I can get a snack with this. And it's not just ass crack. Since I'm also Xavier, I also love Sandra's tits. So, that is a true story. Watch out, Dwight.
Whoa!
Watch out. That's the second most money she's made today on those things. Yeah. Guys, that's all I got.
I was about to cut his mic.
Yeah, because you can't throw stuff at women, right, Lisa?
You literally shouldn't.
You shouldn't. I thought it was funny because I'm a man. In fact, I got a little hard. And if you guys want to look at it, it's $10 in the bathroom. Just, I assume Harley does that, I don't know.
20 to touch it.
20 to touch it. He always has cash, so I can only assume. Guys, how are we feeling tonight? How are we feeling inside? Let's change the room. Yeah. Keep rocking and rolling with this weird ass shit. Let's see how wild the night can get. Why not? Boy howdy. Guys, this next guy, he's a, well, just imagine all the jokes that Mike just did, except from this guy's mouth, and it'll be like, oh, that's funnier. Guys, please get up for Xavier Arnold.
How you guys doing tonight? God bless. Holy shit. I'm supposed to be Mike Callahan. I don't know. I don't, you know, I'm 20 years old. It's really hard for me to channel middle age, Viagra, ravaged by divorce energy. You know what I mean? I don't know how to get that going. Could you, like, I love him. He's a sweet guy. But those shins say, like, I paid for the golf lessons that she ended up leaving me for the instructor. You know what I mean? It's tragic. But me and him are here at the same place. Who am I to judge? We don't do comedy the exact same way. He did a lot of my jokes really well, almost the way I would do them, but the way that the Viagra would make you do them. I'm gonna riff on what he's got. I got two new things. So before I pop the blue chew and become a middle-aged man, I'm still Xavier for like one second. I got like two new things I'm gonna run by you real quick. Joe Biden has fallen 8 times. Publicly. He's on pace for like 10 to 12 falls in one term. These are record numbers. We haven't seen a president fall this hard since Kennedy. This is crazy. You know what I'm saying? This is nuts. Oh my God. Have any of you guys ever been on the news, like the local news? Wait, a couple of you?
Oh, yeah.
June 25th, 2009, Michael Jackson, the king of pop, died. That same day, me and my family went to go swimming at a local beach in Lake of the Ozarks called PB2. If you have a lake house at the lake built before 1975, you can still pump your raw sewage into the lake. You guys love it. It's Party Cove, Whiteout Party. We're having a good time. There's raw shit like 30 yards away, dog. I'm not trying to go on this tangent, but I grew up at the lake and seeing people go down there for like fun, like aggravate. It's not fun. It's garbage. It's a terrible place to like grow up. There's wealth, the most extravagant wealth you've ever seen, and 10 minutes away, just like my mom doing meth. You know what I mean? It's awesome. I mean, it is kind of a party. You should go. You know what I mean? It is kind of fun. Now that you think about it. Shit. Me and my mom. Anyway. Where was I even going with them? When we went swimming, they were doing a news story. The local news was doing a story on how polluted the lake was. And people weren't allowed to swim there. So right as they're recording this story. Hey. Hey. Look at me. I am the captain now. Thank you. Get your drinks ordered. El Rancho burritos, everything's good? All right, so. Jesus, guys, I'm trying to tell you, I was on the news. It was a cool thing. The The lake was so polluted, they do a news story on it right as we're there, all right? So they interview fat little 9-year-old Xavier, being like, I hope I go to the swimming pool later. I'm so hyped, all right? I don't care about Michael Jackson. I don't even know Michael Jackson's dead at this point. We're watching the entire news that night, ready for our little segment. I watched 45 minutes on The King of Pop, okay? After the most mind-numbing infomercial for molestation I could ever watch in my entire life, it finally goes Michael Jackson, King of Pop, 1953 to 2009. Up next, PB2's polluted, shit in the water, and then my fat face. I hope I get to go to the pool later. We'll add more to that over time, but that's it for now. Thank you. I was on the news. They ran the same story the next year, except for Michael Jackson hadn't died. You know, so I'm a year older. I have a little bit more perspective on things. I was like, look at this fat fuck. Who's this guy? Going to the pool, probably with his shirt on. Anyway, earlier this year, a bunch of people were stealing Kias with iPhone chargers. You guys know about this? They were calling them the Kia boys. In Detroit alone, 300 Kias got stolen in one night. Detroit's kind of a garbage city. That's to be expected. But 300 Kias, for them to have a name, the Kia boys, it sounds like a gay porn quartet. You know what I mean? That's amazing. Now you're taking Kia souls. They'll take your soul, the Kia boys. They'll take it from you with an iPhone charger. And a lot of them were found relatively unharmed, just full of blunt ashes and no gas. If my Kia Soul was returned to me, just full of Slapwood's ash and fucking... You know what I mean? You go in, you look at who's paired your phone, and it says fucking, fuck you. I go, these were cool kids. You know what I mean? I can't be too mad. I got my soul back. Alright, so now I'm a Papa Blue Chew, I'm middle aged, my dick don't work. He wrote too old to start doing comedy. Again, I'm 20. I started doing comedy when I was 18. I did it like at the earliest you possibly could almost. You know what I mean? Very much just on the cusp. I didn't have a perspective. I was too young really to do comedy. I was just up there like Forrest Gump's Abe, baby. You know what I mean? Like, no, nothing original by any means. I couldn't imagine being old. I'm scared. I'm really scared. The next thing he wrote was older than the internet. Again, I had a phone at 9. I watched porn at 10. Let's call back to what Mike said. I do love Sandy's tits. Okay? You guys will see Sandy Wally soon, and you will see the tits I'm referring to. They're magnificent. First porn I ever watched at 10 years old. I was in the den on the family computer, fresh off of Minecraft Let's Play. I said, what's porn? I heard about that on the bus. And it was a blonde lady with fake titties and acrylic nails just finger blasting herself on the edge of a hot tub. Again, you guys will see Sandy Wally very soon. You will understand why I love her and her tits. One of the things he has written down is social security number engraved on the bike. Again, I assume this has to do with his age, you know what I mean? But I just think that that's a bad idea. Someone steals your bike, they also have your social security number. They're just out there on a mongoose taking out loans in your name. It's not good for your credit. That's fucked up. You know, you should have put your social security number on your Kia Soul. You know what I'm saying? That'd be up. Kia boys strike again. He wrote, invited my homeless friend camping. Maybe I'm a bad person, but no fucking way I'm hanging out with a homeless guy. You know what? They smell. Also, taking your homeless friend... I'm sorry. Let's get together. Taking your homeless friend camping is just called being roommates. You know what I mean? I don't know. Hey. I am the captain now. Thank you. I only have like two more things to say and I'll get out of your hair. He used to work at a pawn shop, which... I don't know what I got for that. You know what I mean? I remember being 17, I would lie to the guy about how old I was to pawn my dad's video games so I could buy Wii, skip school. was Mike Callahan giving me that weed money. No, it wasn't. It was an old man who's dead now. I'm sorry, guys. I don't, you know. And he told me exactly how he tells these jokes, but I can't do that. I have such a hard time. I have such a bad memory. You ever do 13 bong rips for Jesus Christ and then talk to Mike Callahan on the phone for 15 minutes? I had just landed a plane. I had just landed a fucking plane. And this motherfucker calls me, and you know, I told him to call me, but I thought it would be like a little 5.5 minute phone call. Hey, man, a little just a bit. What's going on with the cats? They drink? No, the cats don't drink. They just, I'm an alcoholic and they puke. Okay, that's the joke. You understand? We vomit together. But no, it was a 15 minute phone call. I don't talk that long to my mother. You understand? Maybe I'm a bad son. Anyway, so, you know. Thank you guys very much. Here's the last thing I have to say. This isn't Mike, and then I'll leave. If, you know, I've never been cheated. I'm never really worried about being cheated on. I think I hold it down as a man in most regards. There's a couple things that I don't do. I hate doing the dishes. You know what I mean? So if a guy, like, fucked my girl and did my dishes, how mad could I be? Have a good night. Drive safe. I love you.
I did, though, message Harley, and yesterday and say I thought of the stupidest thing ever. Can I come in for a minute and a half? And then Harley tonight somehow got even more trashy.
What's up, dude?
I guess they didn't like that one. You like the political impression, so?
Let's hear more.
Yeah. So, yeah, the other night I was watching, I have two TVs because it's almost football season, so I watch two games at all times. Worship my Lord and Savior on Sundays. Patty Mahomes, am I right? That me up, man. But yeah, so it's not quite football season though, but I have the TVs hooked up already, so I've just been watching a movie on one and like a TV show on the other. So the other day I'm watching Pulp Fiction. At the same time, I've got a 9/11 documentary. And then I fall asleep and I have a dream that George W. Bush is in Pulp Fiction.
Yeah.
He's just kind of.
He's a Harold Kumar.
What?
He's a Harold Kumar.
And you're not on the stage. You want to swap sets with me? It sounds sexual when I say it. Yeah, but yeah, I fell asleep and then, yeah. All of a sudden, George W. Bush, in my dreams, is in Pulp Fiction. It's just kind of like, hey, I kept a watch in my ass. Every time I farted, I set an alarm. Why is your name Jules? Did your mother work at a Tiffany's? Thank you, thank you, thank you. Oh, who else? What do you want to hear an impression of? I'm talking about what? Eight? Stormy was tested, okay? I know the best doctors. She's clean, she was very clean. I've never seen so much of clean. Walked in the room, I say, look how clean this procedure is. Who else? No, I'm not being Lisa today. I'm sorry, Lisa, don't go too far with me later. Who else?
Bill Clinton had a book club.
Bill Clinton had a book club.
Ooh.
Yeah. The only book I like is The Great Gatsby.
Nixon
at a whorehouse. Nixon? How old are you? I see that.
Nixon at a whorehouse.
Nixon at a whorehouse?
Nixon at a strip.
Nixon at a strip.
I only have 20. Right.
Valiant.
You Obama.
Obama. Where's Obama at? How about Obama talking about fruit? Michelle's always making me do stuff with fruit. The other day she made me fuck a cantaloupe. If Obama fucked a cantaloupe, it's probably one of the few things we have in common. He's a good guy. Let's see.
Ted Cruz.
Ted Cruz.
On Motherfucking. Have you seen it?
I'm on to something else now. I tried to take out a mortgage from Bouncy House. But inflation is just horrible.
You got one fan, Brad.
What, Lisa? Let's see. All right, I'm gonna do one more impression. You want to hear Ray Romano golfing? All right, y'all gotta close your eyes real quick. Close your eyes. All right, ready?
Come on.
All right, thank y'all very much.
Screamed at him by the audience is the only type of improv that I like. That was the only improv I've ever liked. Guys, wasn't that fun? Aren't you ready for some more weird bullshit in your face? You're already here, so what's done is done. Guys, up next is a wonderful gentleman who's the normal host of this show every week. Please give it up for a bouncing baby beautiful boy, Nick Gorgeous!
And I'm listening to club music. All right, hold on. I need to get in character. Well, now I'm Abby Bajor.
Your whole nipples are showing. This is not FCC.
There we go. Look, we had an NFL Janet Jackson situation happen there for 1 second. But now we're back for good, and now I am once again Abby Bajor. Now, I'm gonna get meta on so many different levels here. Since Abby is also doing a set swap with me, that means I, as Abby Bajor, am going to have to do what Nick Gorgeous usually does and tell roasts of everybody. This might also be because Nick Gorgeous is a hack and a fraud. I do want people to know that is a possibility. All right, first up of the night was Lisa Pockets, everybody.
Yeah.
Lisa said that anyone who got a hard on seeing her in sweatpants and a goatee need to get the fuck out. Lisa, I did not go full chub, but I did get what I like to call a soft on. So I don't know if I need to go or leave. Next up was Brian Walker. Brian was like the before guy on a infomercial about weight loss. Or Brian playing Joe was like the before guy. Damn it, I forgot to tie it into the thing. Or Abby Bajor forgot to tie it into the thing. Joe Butler was up next. Woo! Joe Butler, parentheses, as Brian Walker, in parentheses, made so many fat jokes that Ben Shapiro wants to get him on his network. Ethan Sutton was up next. Woo! Ethan doing an impression of Becky Polachek. A lady was oddly as creepy and the same as Ethan just being Ethan. Yeah. Becky Polachek was up next. She She did not give off Unabomber vibes like Ethan Sutton did. But what she did give off is using explosive devices to rob a sex store, and that is fully within Ethan Sutton territory. Hell yeah. Mike Callahan was up next. He did half of Xavier Arnold's set, which seems appropriate given the relative income levels. Xavier Arnold was up next. Xavier Arnold didn't tell any of Mike Callahan's jokes, which again suggests the relative income levels. And then Brett Diddy was up. Brett Diddy just decided to be himself and then do an impression of Mitch McConnell, and thus did about as well as Mitch McConnell. All right, this is the end of Abby Bajor doing a Nate Borges impression. And now now Abby Bajor is on set, guys. The first joke I have is about Miss Rachel's sex tape, a joke I totally paid attention to before and know the whole story behind. The story behind Miss Rachel's sex tape is that when I was a young girl in church, I'm using everything I, as Abby Bajor, know about myself, knowing myself for about 2 years. I was a kid in the church, and all of a sudden, Miss Rachel started playing her sex tape instead of the VeggieTales. But the thing was, she was using a cucumber. And that was Miss Rachel's sex tape. I'm skipping a joke, but another joke here is, can you help me, Rachel? Put it in. ... in. And in response to that, I think Abby Bajor would have probably watched an episode or two of VeggieTales and maybe gone to a produce aisle and maybe figured some shit out on her own, on my own. Pencil going into a box. Now, again, I completely know the bit that I'm referencing. But the thing is, I, as just somebody that went to school, was used to putting pencils in like actual boxes. So I don't think I quite picked up on the innuendo that I, as Abby, was actually laying down. Pencil in a box. Pencil in a box is what I usually do with the guy I'm seeing. Folks! That was me doing an impression of Nick. Hold on. Jesus Christ. Just a paragraph about the pencil. I'm just gonna read it standing here as Abby. What did this? A doggy? What does a doggy say? Ruff, ruff, good job, yay! If someone's fucking you doggy style, they better be doing a good job. And you should congratulate them. Did you call me a bad girl? You're so silly, hehe. Uh-oh, the pencil fell out of your hole, W-H-O-L-E. Damn it. This makes me Rachel. I want to emphasize there are no commas in this. This makes me Rachel very sad. Let's put work together to put it back. Oh good, it's back. Yay! I remember now where I've heard this before. This is the joke where Abby, I mean me, when I was babysitting children, which, you know, parents trust me, Abby Bager, to do. I was watching a children's show and decided what it would be like if a children's show host talked somebody through masturbation. And I, as Abby Bager, feel like an explanation of that joke as Abby Bager is as good as any of a place to end this set after I've gotten the light. Everybody, please give it up for everyone else that's going on tonight. Give it up for your host, Harley Hushdiker. He's coming up in this set with his fat ass and big tits and cowboy hat.
Abby's really fucked up, you guys. Abby is, I mean, you guys saw her titties fell out. So like,
wow. See the way she slipped in that "I love you" fucking.
I know. Like, I mean, I get it. As Harley, I know that I just attract bisexual women.
It's a curse.
Great. So, guys, that was I feel like I was watching a performance piece. Like a performance art piece that was like really confusing and probably would get an F. But that being said, I did like it. So also, Nick, you totally butchered the Miss Rachel sex tape joke. But only because Abby's like real version is way more graphic. It is. That's, you guys are like in the like splash zone for that joke. And you guys chose us in the front row, so sorry. Speaking of front row, this lady is really gonna get you in the splash zone and get you ready to. Guys, give it up for the wonderful, the very funny Abby Bager! Give it up!
And Holocaust, go for it.
Holocaust, yeah. I wasn't alive then, so don't remember it.
Do you think Nick was?
I don't know, maybe.
For 9/11.
I was alive for 9/11. Everybody in this bar should be.
Oh, right. Oh, look at you calling people out. I'm too young to be here. Not really.
Yeah, we know. Sorry. Yeah, so give it up for Nick, aka Abby. I am coincidentally wearing the same shirt. Damn it. I told him that we shouldn't have done that. So people would just get so confused. Like our blonde, luscious hair, massive tits. I was saying that you have big boobs, Nick.
They have something.
Other than being Jewish, I guess.
Yes.
Jewish and big tits. It's like my big fat Greek wedding, you know? No? Okay. They're like Jewish. Okay, so Nick handed me a post-it note. With his like chicken scratch on it. Like, I have bad handwriting, I'll say it up and down, but like Nick's is like bad. So this is what I understood from it.
It really is.
And I only asked him one thing. So the first one said book, and then it's titled Extreme Teens Being Hurt. That was like, all right. talk about the Holocaust or like what?
Someone give a cough drop to Nick.
Extreme teens heart.
Extreme teens heart?
Yeah.
What does that even mean?
I don't know. It was the title of a book. I elaborate on it in the next
I mean, obviously, that's how you tell jokes, Nick. Thank you for mansplaining that to me. I love being a woman, guys.
But you're a man.
Yeah, I have a tiny penis, and no one can tell because I stuff my pants. Sorry to call you out, Nick.
It's like worming a bird's nest.
I don't want to know. And then it also said underneath extreme teens being hurt, extreme. It said, terrorists in the novel. So I'm like, okay, terrorists in a novel. I don't read. I'm dyslexic. I can't. Don't be sad for me, guys. I saw the Barbie movie, okay? Feminism is fixed. Another one of Nick's bits is he's all in his feelings a lot, you know, like, oh, Nick, I'm all in my feelings all the time, guys. A few reasons why I'm all in my feelings. I'm jealous of dogs. I'm really jealous of dogs. They just get so much energy when you come in the door. Like, think about it. When you walk in the door and you're a dog, they're like, oh, my God, yeah! You know? Nobody likes me. I'm alone forever. My life is misery.
Yes.
Yeah, I'm supposed to be Nick Gorgeous. The next one said, I'm just disappointed in more things. Just like every day, I'm more disappointed than I was the day before. Yeah, right? And then the last one is I'm really mad at birds. I'm just super mad at all the birds. Like, I'm like, get out of here, robots. Like, in my way. My money's already given to a Jewish bank. Because I'm a Jew. You get it?
Yeah.
Because I'm Jewish. I have a Jewish bank.
I'm
Asian. Adding nuns to anything just makes it automatically way sexier.
I agree.
Yeah? Okay, you get it. Or did you go to Catholic school?
Twice.
Wow. So you got kicked out, got a girl pregnant, got kicked out of the other one. Am I your mom? Yeah.
Reading your mind,
yeah. Also, your mom. I say as Nick Gorgeous. Yeah. You guys can't tell, but it's swinging in between these. It is swinging. Massive. Why do you think I have to wear something that doesn't, like, have another pant leg? It just fills it up. Like, the whole way.
Yeah, brother.
That's why I never get laid. It's just too big.
That's exactly
that's why I never get laid. Oh, wow. This is a lot of fun. I sure am loving this. Yeah, so nuns basically make everything sexier or funnier sometimes. They always do the opposite of, you know, what is really needed in the scene. That's all I got. So, thank you for coming out.
Here we go, Robbie Major, everybody! Give it up for her! Wow!
lot to keep track of. And also, Nick's tits are very distracting. Like, there's, I mean, mazel. All right, guys, are you ready to see a few more comics?
Oh, yeah.
And then you'll be finally released from this weird acid trip hell that we're all in. I love it. I'm already high. I'm Harley. I shove the bong up my ass. Like, that is how high I am.
I'm also high because I'm quirky.
I'm high in a relatable way. You're fucked. I guess Harley's... This is hard. It's hard to stay in character.
Yeah.
I have to chug a Bud Light later. I'm not going to like it. But you know what? That's show business, bitch. Let's keep going. Let's keep going. Guys, you're going to see a series. We've been calling them the triplets tonight.
Yeah, it's a trio of people swapping around.
Swapping STDs and licking.
Yeah, like an old folks home in Florida. Just really
the next three men that come up, they have all had sex with each other. That's what we're trying to say. But up first in this little trio of set swappy sex time is one of my favorite little overall models. Guys, give it up for Wyatt Parsons!
Marrero tonight, how we doing? Yeah? Good time, glad to hear it. It's always fun doing a set swap when you're pretending to be someone else because you get to just read their jokes verbatim. So I'm just going to jump right into what Lewis wrote for me.
Yeah!
I didn't write anything
for you. Fuck, it's all in Spanish. Fuck.
Fuck
you. You almost fucked that up. I'll let it slide though. I was recently watching the Sharknado movies. Anybody seen any of these Sharknado movies? No Sharknado movies. I like them. I think the only way to improve the Sharknado formula is we gotta get Steven Seagal in the Sharknado franchise, right? Steven Seagal. I like Steven Seagal. He always looks like he's looking in the sun. You know? And he always says lines that don't really make sense. They're like, Steven, we got sharks and tornadoes. And he's like, we're gonna ice you real good. We're gonna take him out. And he's always like fighting while he's sitting down. It's like, what the fuck are you doing? I can't kick as high as Harley, but I'll try. Does anybody here go to church? Any churchgoers up in the house? Any lovers of the Lord up in here? I like church. I think church, the only way we can improve on church is if instead of pastors announcing it, we get monster truck announcers to like hype it up, you know? Like, Sunday, Sunday, Sunday! Come on down! He is risen! Come check it out! Only this Sunday! Get your tickets now! That's all I remember that joke, but it's really good. Oh God, how do you keep this energy up, bro? Fuck. Alright, this next couple stuff is some stuff I have written. It's my own stuff, kind of. Does anyone notice Japanese people are really good at skateboarding? That's all I got written, I don't know, it's just an observation. This one's kind of funny because I'm pretending to be Lewis. I saw a really funny post on Threads, the new like Twitter or whatever the other day. And, oh God, I'm so tired. And saw a post the other day and it was just a post or whatever. And it said, it was a picture of a packet of soy chorizo. And it said, I bought this soy chorizo thinking it was regular chorizo. Because I thought it was Spanish for I am chorizo. And I read that and I was like, we're not going to make it as people, are we? Becky said Ethan only watches little people porn. Have you ever seen any of my work, bro? I actually have films written, like I'm an auteur or some shit. Brett was up here, did a lot of great impressions. Can we get a round of applause for Brett? I only have one impression I do kind of well, and you might be a little surprised, but I do a pretty good Louis Armstrong impression. Louis Armstrong, so give me a second. It takes a second to get the voice. This is my Louis Armstrong impression. Alright. Ooh, I'm so winded. Abby, when she was up here doing Nick's jokes, she kept referring to them as Nick's bits. And I think that sounds like kosher dog treats. I got one final joke for y'all. I just want to give a shout out to Becky for being able to decipher Ethan's manifesto. Ha-cha! Alright, thank you guys for coming out. Have a nice night.
I'm Chris Pratt. I don't know. I saw the first 15 minutes. I don't know. Guys, up next is the man, the myth, the legend. You just saw him have an impression done of him, and you're going to love the real thing, I hope. Yeah, guys, yeah. Please welcome Louis Marrero.
Hey, yo, what's up, everybody? How you doing? Hey. Yeah, I wish I was that cool in real life. Jesus Christ, everybody's been doing a fantastic job. That was super, super fun. I'm sorry, that just got me going. That was nice, I almost cried. That was really nice. I'd like to point out how your junk looks way better in sweatpants than Harley's actually does. And don't ask me how I know. I've worked very closely with Harley for a long time. We're homies. We're bros. Hope the Mountain Dew is flowing back there for you guys. that was fucking great. Give it up for Wyatt Parsons. That was fucking fantastic. You guys have no idea how it is to like see how stupid you look all the time in front of everybody else. And so, shit, let's get to it. He wrote me notes. Yeah, like I could read. Especially English. Like, get the fuck out of here. Like, this motherfucker wrote me notes. Like, I can't read English. I can't read at all. I can't even barely tell time. Like, I can't, like, it's fucked up. Like, Puerto Ricans, we only know what time it is by how far the plantain tree grows. So let's get this going with Wyatt. I've loved Wyatt for a very long time. And by the way, somehow I got into doing two dudes. Yeah, I'm doing two dudes. Mike, you know what's up. Mike knows what the fuck is up with two dudes. I am doing two dudes tonight. And trust me, I know how to do two dudes. Yeah!
Okay.
Yeah! Calm down. It's not that exciting. Take notes. No, take notes from Lisa. Jesus Christ, did you see that shit in her pants?
Yeah, I'm a queen.
Yeah. Dude, I mean, where's Kevin? Fuck, Kevin, are you okay? Dude. Wow. Ouch. Ouch. Kevin's our fiance, by the way. I mean, everybody knows she pegs him. Like, it's a thing. Like, it's a thing. When they got engaged, she put out the whole thing. Oh my God, look at my ring. I love him. It's the love of my life. I'm so in love, blah, blah, blah. And all those peggings I did, he still wants me. And that's fucking fantastic. I love you. Okay, let's do Wyatt Parsons jokes. Right? Wyatt comes over. And this is really fucked up, so let me try to be Wyatt. You guys like NASA? NASA's great. I have a mustache now. I took it from a Mr. Potato Head thing, but whatever. I'm skinny. Yeah, and I'm little. She's about it. sit down. Next to her. I said, I'm skinny. She was like, yeah, bro. All right, whatever. Okay. This is so weird. I suffer from Benjamin Button disease. I'm 65 years old. I always feel like you do this. Like you're really uncomfortable like I am right now. Because I can't move. I can't move like I usually move. Because I'm trying to do you. Let's read Wyatt's jokes. I fucking hate all of you. I worry about the wind. Because I'm a skinny guy. Thank you. That's fantastic. I'm so glad you like that. I'm so glad. Oh my god. Ah, finally, one person. I've never experienced racism because you're white. That's literally, I know I read it before. Like, I really can't read. I was just joking before. I've never experienced racism, once again, because you're white. But I have been turned away from a go-kart course as an adult for not being tall enough. Yeah, bro, that's not a joke. That's a fucking fact. You're little. That's why I love you. I can put you in my pocket. And take you. Some of us are not as good at these things. Yeah. 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 It's fine. You're fine. We're all fine. We're all doing the best we can. We all love each other. That's what matters. And Wyatt is single. He is single. Thank you.
I love you.
No, you don't. Son of a bitch, Wyatt. I have to do two people. The other one is Will Evans. Do you know how hard that is? That is super hard. I am not that fucking high. Like, it is super fucking hard. Like dead ass. Like, I feel like if a chick sucked his dick, she tripped balls for like 5 days. Okay? So, like, let's. And I'm not even gonna get to him yet. Jesus Christ. You wanna. What is it? Buttholes, right? Okay. Cat buttholes. Son of a bitch, I hate all of you. Okay. Had a chick message me, thank you for the light. You have no idea. Comics always hate the light.
You do not hate the light tonight.
Yeah, I do not hate the light tonight. The light is fantastic. The light is the fucking best. I had a chick message me on Hinge. What's Hinge? What's Hinge? It's a dating app?
Yeah.
What's it hanging on? Like, is that a thing? Really?
Dad hope.
What?
Dad hope.
You say dad hope?
Dad hope. Or that.
Dad hope. Dad hope. Oh my god, I bet your first husband hates you. Okay. I had a chick message me on Hinge. I had a chick message me on Hinge. And her message was, are you the comedian with the huge cock? That's hilarious. Oh, shit. Oh, no, hold on. I didn't know how to reply. I don't know how to reply. I don't consider myself a comedian. And you know what? I feel that way right now. And thank you very much. I'm so glad that you got to prosper from a brown man's success, just like the rest of your family has. Brown man has. I wish I could do Will Evans stuff, but I should get the fuck out of here. But cat buttholes are great because they shit and you don't have to wipe them because they have to. The suction. Yeah. Is it a suction? No? Okay, this guy knows. You should really talk to him. It's on Play-Doh, this motherfucker right here. Yo, I'm literally. I'll talk to you later. Give it up for Harley Bush. We can't get enough. Damn, bro.
two white dudes to do the same job as one Latino. But like, white people suck, am I right? Like the first white person came to America and he was like, what is that? What is that? What is that laying over there? What is that laying over there? I want it. And he just took it, okay? And like, white people are still like that today. Just like, look at Will Evans, you know, every time he smokes a joint, he's just like, whoa, what is that? What is that? But yeah, I have a Mexican girlfriend. My girlfriend's a Mexican. And having a Latina girlfriend is like the greatest thing ever, because like, they don't care if like you live with your parents, they just think that you really love your family, you know, not that you can't afford your own house. And then not only that, you know, like, if you have any conflict at all at a restaurant, at a anything with anybody, they can do it. You know, they can just be feisty, you know, because they're short, you know, and everything is great, you know, and it's really nice to be a Latino right now because I'm 5'9" and that's tall for a Latino, so it feels really nice.
Good job, man. Good job.
It feels real nice.
You know, why people like you? You guys don't know how to do cologne, okay? You guys don't know how to spray cologne, okay? You guys don't do cologne enough. You guys don't prepare for how much you're gonna dance and sweat, and you just end up smelling like cheese, you know? Like Latinos, we know that we're gonna smell like a burrito if we said, so we put the cologne everywhere, you know? You got here, like the Gucci, you gotta spray it all over, you know, all over. That's what you gotta do. Spray it, everything. Will should really do this, you know, because he really fucking needs it. You know, church is great, but what they really need, they need to advertise it like monster trucks, like a monster truck show. You know, like, every day they're like, you know, they're like, Sunday, you know, one day out, you know, Christ, he's risen, you know, free donuts, you know, the Bud Light girls will be there. That's what you miss, right? You get the Bud Light girls. You can't have that show without the Bud Light girls, because, I don't know. I never get that joke because, like, dude, like, everyone who goes to church loves monster trucks, you know, like, it's not, it's a thing, but, you know, it won't be a Louis set without the monster truck joke. So, that's all I got, because I can't do that page without some cocaine, so, you guys have a great rest of your night, thank you.
Inside the toilet?
Yes.
Okay. Becky said yes. Great. That's what you do with the strap on, I think. I don't know. I do know. Guys, the last comic we have up tonight is, wow, just a real hoot and a half. You've been hearing from her all night. And boy, howdy, is she a real spitfire. Yeah! Give it up for Harley Fischneiker, the OG, the original!
I just want to start out by saying I'm Lisa, and this tattoo is hers. She got that when she was 17 and bad at making choices. So the first thing that's written down here is winky feet. So I can only assume that I'm starting up a very, very prestigious feet picks company, LLC. I'm looking at all the white men here. Teach me how to form an LLC. Come on. Can you teach me how to form an LLC? You got me in 45 minutes. A YouTube video can do it in 5. So, be better, white man. Be better. I'm not as agile as I used to be. I'd love to run around and be super energetic like when I was 17 and I first started comedy. But I broke my ankle. You can still see the scars here. I was at a Renaissance festival, and one of the knights, who was a man, said that I couldn't beat him in a joust. And so I got on that horse, and I jousted him. I hit him right in the chest, because I'm a strong woman, and I got good aim. He hit me in the fucking ankle. He broke my ankle. Fucking incompetent man. He broke my ankle. Oh, he got me. I broke character. I can see how it's really hard to keep character when you're too... All right. The next thing that is written down for me is magnesium. And I think that man was just trying to confuse me with big words that he thought I wouldn't know. But I know magnesium's a metal. Well, we're going to move on before I run out of information to talk about. Magnesium. I'm an art major, you know.
Ow!
I use magnesium to paint sometimes. My fiance Kevin's here. Kevin, yeah! Yeah, cheer for me. Me and Kevin, every night before bed, you know, like when we're both just gotten out of the shower and we're like moist with water, you know, both of our skin's extra soft from the Dove lotion. He uses my lotion now. That's how whipped he is. And when we're both super silky soft, we just get in front of the mirror, him behind me, and we just wave our hands like this so that it looks like I have four arms and that his penis is dropping below my crotch. So like I have a penis and I just go, would you fuck me? I'd fuck me. Would you fuck me? Would you fuck me? I'd fuck me. I got big lips. Some would call them BJ lips. You know, God gifted them to me. He gave me rather large lips. But he also gave me large teeth. That's why he made me a Taylor Swift fan. Yeah. I like horses. I also like the Hannah Montana movie. Like, I'm a girl, guys. This weird recurrent fantasy I've had ever since I was a young child and I was watching Mr. Rogers' television show. You know, like when you have that first thing you masturbate to, it kind of sticks around for a little while. And Mr. Rogers was that for me. Could you imagine how Mr. Rogers' sex tape would go? You know? Would the foreplay be taking off the house shoes, setting them off to the side? Would his sex tape be brought to you by viewers like you? Thank you for sponsoring the sex tape. You know, I just picture him like pants off, but he's still wearing like a nice sweater while he's fucking me. I'm just getting fucked, and then sweaters, it's kind of itchy, but I like it, you know, it's a little... It's like, it's itchy, but my ass itched, you know? So, like, I'm not complaining. Alright, can I do one last thing? Can I get a shout out to all the women in here for supporting local comedy? We are stronger than all of these dumb fucking men in here. Let's start showing it, ladies. Let's finesse some free drinks. Starting with whoever wants to buy me one. My name's Lisa Pockets.
Woo!
I don't know, I turned back into Harley there
show.
That was a show. Yeah. Wow, you are all here for a show. And you know what? It's a sad time at the end of the show.
Because unfortunately, it is ending tonight. We do want to go home at some point. But before we do, we're going to roast all of the comedians you've seen perform tonight.
Yes, we are. Yes, we are. You guys want to hear some saucy little tight roasts? Yeah, all these fucking turds that you saw tonight. Love it. Guys, up first is Brian Walker. Give it up for Brian Walker. Yeah. Here the show. You good, Lisa?
I lost my phone.
Women are so cool.
I should have used these fucking skirt pockets, but I...
Yeah, I specifically gave you a skirt with pockets.
I respect you for giving me that, and I didn't use it. I'm sorry, I let feminism down.
You don't deserve to even look at Margot Robbie. All right, well, I guess I'll do my roast while you do that. Did you?
Oh, I got it.
You got it, okay. All right, here are the roasts. Harley, Lisa has her phone, dumb whore that she is. So Brian Walker was first. Do you have a roast for Brian?
Brian is the reason I tried to soak with Kevin. He just inspired us. I thought if we just laid there and did nothing that we would feel an intimacy. And we did. That's why we're getting married. You can woo us.
You're welcome.
You can. Yeah, you can woo if you want. So glad that I, Harley, am hosting this show. Because we all know how much Brian loves female comedians. He loves them so much. Maybe you don't know that, but I think you should assume by looking at him that he's not a big fan. That joke was only for me. And by me, I mean Harley. Guys, let's keep it going. Who was up next? Joe Butler. Our beautiful Joe Butler. We love him so much.
Joe looks like Brian if he did just enough meth to take his IT job to tech millionaire. You can picture Joe driving around in a Tesla, bragging about his IT job. Yeah, you can see it.
And hoping that he dies. Sorry, when I see like 20-year-olds driving Teslas, I want to kill myself. Anyone else? Yeah. Anybody else? Okay. And you're at 20. Are you 19? We'll talk about it. I've hit on you, so hopefully you're not too young. I'm saying that as Harley. Harley's a creep, guys. All I wrote down for Joe was, haha, yeah, fuck Brian. That's all I wrote. Guys, Ethan Sutton was up next. Let's hear it for Ethan Sutton. Wow.
Ethan doing poetry was the most empowering feminine moment of the night.
Only the second most empowering moment is when Nick took out his tits.
I thought you were going to talk about when Ethan talked about the real issues like period panties and how real women use cups.
It's true.
Yeah.
I mean, I wouldn't know I'm a man. If Ethan ate Becky's pussy, then that's what happened to Lisa and I's baggie of Coke. That's where we've been storing it. It's warmer. You ever had a warm Coke? It's great. Nobody? That's fine. You guys are rock and roll like me and Harvey. Great, you got any more for Ethan?
No.
Great. Guys, Becky Polachek was up next. Let's hear it for Becky.
Like the typical white man he is, wanted to write a joke in defense of racism, but just couldn't think of one.
I like that Becky and Ethan both want to eat Anne Frank's pussy. And isn't that what comedy camaraderie is really all about?
Speaking of that, Becky, I think, wants to clone himself so he can double penetrate Anne Frank. That's the gist I got from tonight's set.
A lot of Anne Frank sex jokes.
A lot of them.
More than I had anticipated. Yeah. I didn't assume zero, but I did not assume at least three. Guys, Mike Callahan was up next. Let's hear it for him, Mike.
I don't know why, but when Mike was doing all of those jokes about Mike Parsons, I was like, they're actually friends in real life. They met each other like, I'm Mike, you're Mike.
We both like Transform.
I love Mike's frightened white guy version of Xavier Sett. Like when he told that like white cop and black kid joke, he was like, "I'm Xavier." Oh, don't get mad at me. Oopsie daisy, I shouldn't be up here. Guys, Xavier Arnold is up next. Let's hear it for him.
Xavier at his young age has now done enough drugs that he has to use the same amount of Viagra as I does. It's accomplishment, it really is.
I like that.
Xavier made a point to say raw shit within moments of starting his set. That's it. I just liked that. That's the only thing I wrote. Guys, up next was Brett Diddy. Let's hear it for Brett! The impressionist extraordinaire.
Brett can impersonate anyone that the crowd can shout out as long as the crowd shouts out a wealthy white American who is running for office. If they shout out that very specific group, he can impersonate
them. I'm sure Mitch McConnell does a killer George Bush impression. Surprisingly good. Guys, the one and only Nick Gorgeous was next. Let's hear it for Nicky.
Nick looks like one of the cheerleaders from The Longest Yard. Also, does anyone else think Nick looks like a Jewish Joey Diaz? He had his belly out. No?
I can live with that.
Hey, Jewish Joey Diaz is pretty good, Nick.
At one point, Nick said, "Nick Gorgeous is a hack and a fraud." And that sentence was locked and loaded in Nick's mind because he says it to himself in the mirror every morning.
Speaking of Nick being a hack and a fraud, he did a... I switched to the wrong joke. Speaking of Nick being a hack and a fraud, Nick read Abby's jokes like he was a father reading his daughter's diary. Just didn't know what to make out of most of them.
I hope in that scenario you're still imagining the father is like wearing a crop top during that.
Oh yeah, Nick is a very supportive father.
Yeah. Guys, speaking of crop tops, Abby Major is up next. Let's hear it for Abby Major.
I think Nick handed Abby a post-it that was written completely in Hebrew.
I like that one, Lisa.
Thank you.
I do too.
Thank you, Harley. You always have the best sense of humor.
Yeah, well, I'm kind of stupid. at one point, Abby said, "Extreme teens being hurt." And that's one of Nick's chicken scratch notes. But ironically, I think it still applies to Abby's life because as a young teen, she used to be a BMX bike rider. She wasn't, but I thought that was fun.
Abby did a spot-on Nick impression by only getting laughs when he said the word Jew. It's the only time he gets laughs. Good at it, bro.
Guys, Wyatt Parsons was next. Let's hear it for Wyatt.
Wyatt on the stage running around like that looked like he was trying to learn a dance routine for the next Step Up movie. Step Up 4D, have they done that yet?
And boy, is that audition going to be disappointing. Wyatt, there's a reason Lewis doesn't actually ever wear overalls on stage. And that's because it restricts his mobility. Yes. I mean, you did a great job. But it's basically like a blanket on you. Hey, guys, Lewis Marrero's up next. Can we hear from Lewis?
Lewis spends his entire set like the adopted stepfather of Wyatt, just disciplining him for how bad his jokes were. Alright, I'm gonna do some of Wyatt's jokes.
That makes sense because I was a little scared of him during that set. At one point, Lewis said, "You guys don't know what it's like to see how stupid you look on stage." And then I wrote, "They actually do know how stupid we look on stage. They are well aware. Especially you front row fucks." I'm so sorry. Guys, Will Evans was next. Let's hear it for him!
unfortunately, he couldn't be here for the end of the show. He had to return back to a shift at El Rancho.
While watching Will impersonate Lewis, I just realized that Will Evans' version of doing cocaine is just pretending to be Lewis Marrero. It's all it takes. Way less expensive. Guys, and the incomparable Harley Buschdiker closed out the show.
I.E. Lisa Pockets.
Yourself, I suppose.
I guess, yeah. I wrote a bunch of stuff. That's mostly nonsense. Harley took my foot injury in a weird direction. I know this might be surprising to you, but I've never once been to a Renaissance fair.
What, how the hell were you jousting? Because we'll talk about that after this show.
we'll talk about it later. It's a sex term, but that's... We'll talk about it. It's a sex term.
Whoa.
Also, at no point during the, like, naked Kevin and Lisa joke, did you mention Silence of the Lambs?
Fuck. Is that the whole point of the smooth skin?
I know, yes!
I mentioned the smooth skin, like, 7 times. I didn't know why, though. It was Silence of the Lambs. I got it, though.
It's fine. It's okay. It only needs to be referenced once a show for me to feel okay about it. Guys, that's it.
That's the end of the show. We do this every single Tuesday.
Wow!
At 9 o'clock. We also have other events like karaoke on the weekends.
Yeah.
Come out and check it out. We are open till 1 o'clock. Hang around. Talk to us. We're lonely.
Yeah, Harley put on a skirt, and I literally dyed half my hair. So, you know, in show form, show us how much you appreciate either of our efforts. That would be great. Guys, thanks so much. Have